Is atheism a religion? I've spoken with many atheists who have been frustrated by Christians who say that atheism is a religion, because while atheists want nothing whatsoever to do with religion or belief, they want to distance themselves as much as they can from faith because they want to say that their worldview and their frame in which to understand reality is based on what is accepted as fact, and they don't want to allow anything that sounds like belief or faith or religion into their worldview, lest they give any other worldview which has beliefs or faith give it any credence. So I can understand why an atheist would be frustrated indeed whenever they're told that what they believe or accept is in fact a religious belief or even a belief at all. An atheist would respond by saying that atheism is to religion as not collecting stamps is to stamp collecting. It's not a hobby to not collect stamps, and it's not a religion to not have a religion or to not have a belief in God. Now, a question I would like to ask is this: are all beliefs religious in nature? That's something you need to ask yourself. Let me ask the question again. Are all beliefs religious in nature? Allow me to give a few beliefs that one could possibly hold that I don't think would be religious in nature. I believe that my favorite hockey team is going to win the hockey game. Notice I didn't mention God or the Bible, just a hockey game. Is that religious in nature? So again, we're going to have to be very careful with how we define religious belief as opposed to any other belief. Now, if you say, no, even believing that a hockey game, you know, that someone winning a hockey game is going to happen, that is a religious belief in the sense that, well, you don't know. And if you don't know something and you believe it, that's a religious belief. So yes, a religious belief can even be a hockey game, you know, regarding a hockey game. It doesn't have to do with God, if one wants to use that definition. So if that is your definition of religious belief, is to believe something for which you don't actually know with absolute certainty, then under that definition, I would say atheism is absolutely a religious belief. Allow me to argue for that. Let's take a look at these two sentences, which look very much the same but are actually very different. Sentence number one says, "This guy does not believe in the existence of God." Sentence number two says, "This guy believes that God does not exist." Now, at first hearing, those might sound like they're saying exactly the same thing. But if we replace God with something else, we'll see that these are actually very different. Let's go back to sentence number one. Sentence number one says, "This guy does not believe that his mom is at the store." Sentence number two says, "This guy believes that his mom is not at the store." Now, it's not hard to imagine someone saying, "I do not believe that my mother is at the store." If I was to say, "I do not believe that my mother is at the store," that doesn't mean that I'm not open to the possibility that she actually might be. It just means I don't presently have the affirming belief such that I'm convinced that she is there. But, at the same time, I'm not entirely convinced that she isn't. I just don't presently believe that she is. Now, think how different the statement, "I do not believe my mother is at the store," is from this: "I believe my mother is not at the store." Now, I'm affirming the negative. I'm saying my conviction is that she's not there. That is entirely different from saying, "I do not believe that she is there." And so we have two kinds of atheists. We have the one that says, "I believe that God does not exist," and the atheist who says, "I do not believe that God exists." Now, the atheist who says, "I do not have the belief," remember, they want to say that atheism is not a belief. So they have to be of the first kind. They have to be the one that says, "I do not believe that God exists," which means they have to be open to the possibility, which means they're no longer an atheist, they're now an agnostic. The person of the second type who says, "I believe that God does not exist," that's a religious belief. And so the conclusion is inescapable. You're either an agnostic or a religious atheist. You believe that there is no God. And if you're not comfortable with that, you're going to have to switch over to the agnostic position and say, well, I do not believe that God exists. That would be an agnostic position. You're open to the possibility. But you see, the leading atheists here on YouTube would never want you to be that. They would want you to be the kind that says, I believe that God does not exist. When they're asked questions like, well, what created the universe? They'll respond by saying, well, I don't know. But I believe that it wasn't God, and they're committed to that idea every bit as the Christian is committed to the idea that God does exist. They're both religious beliefs. And the atheist betrays himself when they vehemently oppose anyone believing that perhaps God did create the universe, because their commitment to the belief that God didn't create the universe is every bit as much of a belief as the alternative. So why are they so committed to opposing, well, the existence of God? Maybe it's because what the Bible says is true, that they hate him. They know he exists, they hate him, and they want nothing to do with him. Oh, and if you believe in God, they'll hate you too, just like Jesus said. It's a religious belief, because to say, I believe that God does not exist, is a belief. End of story. And so it all comes down to your definition of a religious belief. If believing that someone is going to win a hockey game is a religious belief, then believing that there is no God is equally a religious belief. Now, if you want to say that, well, winning a hockey game isn't, you know, regardless if you believe it or not, that's not a religious concern. We wouldn't classify that as religious. Religion has to do with theism. It has to do with belief in God or gods, deities of that nature. Even under that definition, the non-belief in a deity is theistic in nature, because it's you're doing theology when you're affirming or denying theological claims. To say God exists or to say God does not exist is a theological statement. And so it's within the realm of theology, and therefore, atheism is, in a strange sort of way, a theistic belief. Although it's atheistic, and thus meant to be the counterpoint to theism, by very definition of its engagement with theism, it's actually a category within the discourse. With that being said, there's also one final concern. I know this video has probably upset a lot of people, and that's good. And that's really good, because atheism is absolutely a religious belief. It's absolutely a religious belief, because even within atheism, if we want to use a strict atheist definition of religion, because, well, I'm a Christian, so this, you know, whole video has been from a Christian perspective, let's grant the atheist their position. To an atheist, there's no God, supposedly. There's no soul. There's no immaterial, spiritual, none of that sort of stuff. So everything is material. Now, if everything's material, then you... That's my cat. If everything is material, well, then that means all your thinking, the brain, well, that's just material too. So the chemicals in someone's brain that makes them affirm the existence of God, well, how are they very different from those chemicals which make them deny the very same concept? I mean, both conceptualize God the same way, supposedly, in order for one to affirm it and deny it. If we're not talking about the same thing, if we're not talking about the same concept of God, then how can we say that one's denying of God is the same as the other's affirming? If you're denying what I'm affirming, it has to be the same thing. So the concept, which, if you want to boil it down to a material object or a part of the brain, within an atheist or a theist, within an atheistic worldview, they're very, very similar. They're both engaging with the same matter. They're both using a similar brain. They're both engaging with the same concept, which I imagine goes on in the same region of the brain. And the difference between affirming or denying a particular concept, well, it's really not that big of a difference. If I believe that there is a bottle of water in front of me, and another person does not believe that there's a bottle of water in front of them, well, both have the concept of the bottle of water, and there's just a slight difference. One affirms and one denies. And it's very easy to see that you could switch from going from denying to affirming very quickly. Observe. I do not presently believe that there's a ping pong paddle in front of me. Now I do. The difference between my two brain states really wasn't that big of a difference. One just affirmed and the other denied. But unless at both points I understood what a ping pong paddle was, neither the affirmation or the denying would be said to be an affirmation or denying of a ping pong paddle. So to believe in God or to not believe in God, both require an understanding and a concept of God in order to do the affirming or the denying. And within an atheist worldview, the material brain, which affirms and denies the existence of God, both has the concept of God in order to affirm and deny it. And so the affirmation or denying of God, if one was to say that the affirming of God is a religious brain reaction, then the denying of God would equally be so. A true atheist within an atheist worldview would have no concept of God whatsoever and neither be able to affirm or deny it. They wouldn't even know what God was. But the fact is, we all know what God is. Because, well, even Helen Keller, who was born deaf, blind, and mute, when she learned to communicate and started talking about God, she said that she had always believed in God even before anyone had communicated the idea to her or she was even able to communicate. It's intrinsically part of us to know God, just as the Bible says, and to deny God's existence is a religious belief. Oh, and one more thing. What is an atheist's definition of religion from an atheist worldview? Since there is no spiritual reality to them, religion, socially speaking, is just a gathering of a bunch of people who mentally assent to a particular idea, who have particular people in authority, and have particular books which are authoritative. Now, atheism is exactly that. It's a group of people who identify them with a particular label. They gather on occasion. They have particular teachers and leaders that they look up to. They have particular documents that they find authoritative. Sociologically, atheism is a religion. If it wasn't, you wouldn't call yourself an atheist. It would not be anything. There would be no association. There would be no teachings. There would be no teachers. But they are a religion, even from an atheistic view. Because from an atheistic view, there is no difference between a religion and non-religion because there's no spiritual reality. Religion is just a sociological behavior of a gathering of people mentally assenting to certain ideas. And that is exactly what atheists do. It's exactly what atheists do. Atheism is a religion, even from an atheistic definition.